diarrhea's coming back. My family's under attack.
It's not so great, I do agree. I've also got a bad wedgie.
Thought I could prove I'm not a baby, but now all of us need saving.
Drop my hopes into the ocean. Sorry if a fish is choking.
Sure, a lot is happening, but I wish I brought my napkin thing. It might have helped to calm us down.
Everybody hush! Don't make a sound!
But why are you doing all this?
Okay, good question. I'll allow it. Look, I'm not bad. Even though I'm not a bad person, so I killed one carnival. Well, it's just cause I'm determined to finally get what I think that I'm deserving and to turn it into something worthy. Trust me, I'm sure you will agree. Would you like to hear my master plan? Okay, can you answer faster? Cause I asked you, would you like to hear my master plan?
Yes.
Okay, that's more like it. I'm so glad that you asked. You see, I'm in the fish owner family trust because I'm in the family.
Well, barely.
He's from the bad part of the family.
He means the poor part. They're bad because they're poor.
Shut it! Shut your front door!
Okay, okay. Yeah. I said okay.
So, in this family trust, you see, you're ineligible to receive benefits if you've been convicted of a felony. And every single one of them has been. All except for cousin Calvin, because he never got caught.
Yeah, baby.
Shush! So I frame him and boom! Now if something unfortunate happens to Calvin and Felix, whom will they suspect? Not me. No, no, no. Why would they?
Something unfortunate is going to happen to us?
Yes. Surprise.
Oh, poo.
Wait, both of us?
Yeah, sorry. You were so insistent about going with your brother to Cuba.
I bought an outfit.
Yes, we know. But let's just say your submarine isn't going to go to Cuba.
Oh. Cancun?
It won't make it out from under the pier.
Oh my.
Oh dear.
Did you think that sub was going to make it to Cuba?
I think we might have gotten a little too excited about the sub idea.
I mean, isn't it just an old ride?
Yes, it runs on tokens.
But not the best frame job, right? I mean, why bury Cotton Candy down in front of our restaurant and then wait 6 years?
Right.
I didn't bury him in front of your restaurant and I didn't want to wait 6 years! 6 years!
Easy, easy. Maybe we should hold off on the questions.
I had it all worked out. A top-rate murder! I shoot Mr. Carney with Calvin's gun. I stick him in a pile of dirt or whatever yucky stuff was near the entrance to the wharf. I leave the stupid foot sticking out so someone would be sure to see it. But little did I know that some numbskull backhoe operator working for the city was gonna scoop up that pile without even checking for dead carnies. I come back, I got nobody, I didn't know where they brought the dirt, and it's not like I could go around asking, hey, what's the word? Did anyone find any dead guys this tall, kind of a biter? It was a nightmare. But thankfully, blessedly, your stupid pipe burst and saved the day. The skeleton was found, frame job back on, and it's true what they say. Good things happen to good people.
Wait a second, is this all about your silly mega park idea?
Yes, this is about my mega park, my much more efficient and profitable than your stupid pier mega park. It'll have gift shops, so many gift shops, and so much parking, and I'll get the best marketers to do the best marketing and indoor motion simulator rides. If you could see my scale models, then you'd understand why Cotton Candy Dan had to die. It's gonna be so worth it.
Okay.
Because business dreams are about business. They're not about dreams.
That's not true.
All right then, I think I got it figured out. I think that this is what I need. You're gonna all get in the sub and then I'll launch you in the sea.
No, no, I don't think that's right.
No, that's right. You won't be able to get out, the handle's broken from inside. Then the pier will be on fire.
What?
Well, you caused it, then you died.
Oh, that's so careless.
Yeah, what they'll say is this. Metal wheels on metal tracks will cause a spark, a little flare. Whoops, the drapes, they catch on fire, and it just gets worse from there. Up it goes into the molehill, which now seems to be quite full of cute and fluffy, very burny, flammable stuffed animals.
So they don't come to life?
I guess not.
And then the molehill turns into molehell.
That's what we call Dad's back.
We do?
So many problems with this plan.
Like what? People on the pier? Gone. I'm closing early. What else?
You would burn in the fire too?
Nope. I made a fuse out of cooking oil, sugar, and balloon string. All things you'd find in an amusement pier. It's gonna go up the stairs, over the roof of this stupid room. And arson investigators will never suspect a thing. My my fuse and my brilliant flammable stuffed animals idea isn't just enough time to get back to the gym, which is my alibi. I went there just an hour ago. I said the steam room was too steamy. I made a pretty damn big show. Then I slipped out the window, and that's how I got here now. I just sneaked back in through the window, and boom, I've been at the gym 3 hours.
I don't know if you have 3-hour gym body. Sorry.
Yeah, it's not believable.
No, you're too pasty.
Also, your mega park is mega dumb, and so are you.
I want to amend my earlier statement.
Here we go.
Ugh. I'm not that evil, but I'm feeling evil too.